We'll be on the 8 to 4 shift. Right, they're all the officers of the day. I'll just run through the others. On the 8 to...
Oh, sorry!
Hurry up, Birdsworth. On the 8 to 4 shift, starting on the 11th, there'll be Bennett, Jackson, Powell, and Barry. Birdsworth!
Oh, didn't mean to touch it. I'm just finding out whose it was.
Don't be ridiculous. You'll find yourself on loss of privileges because of this.
I wasn't going to take anything, Mrs. Jackson. I've just got to lay my hands on some money, that's all. Otherwise, she'll kill me and I'll be in terrible trouble.
What sort of trouble?
You'll be in more trouble if you don't tell us.
Well, it's that Kay White. I don't want to lag on her or anything.
Look, I won't tell you again.
Well, she's been running this poker school for the last couple of nights. We only play for fun, you know, but she's a real gambler. And she bids very high stakes, and I'm into her for a lot of money. And you know what a bad temper she's got and how strong she is. Well, she reckons that if I don't pay her, I'm going to be a goner. And I don't know what to do, Miss Bennett.
What's the matter?
Well, now, why should anything be the matter?
Just getting our steak for tonight's game, that's all.
What game?
Poker. We're celebrating. It's going to be a big night.
Oh, what have you got to celebrate?
Well, Kevin and me, we're back together. If we had got out like we were meant to, well, we'd have botched things up real good and proper.
Yeah, and it sure gave me a hell of a scare, I can tell you that. It's the last time I'll do anything on the spur of the moment.
Do you know what went wrong?
Some of your lady luck must have rubbed off on us. If Lizzie hadn't spotted Vera in time, we would all been hung, drawn and quartered.
Do you mean she just happened to be there?
That's right. Good old reliable Vera the Vulture.
Oh, you were lucky, weren't you?
Hey, why don't you join us tonight?
No, thanks. I don't want Vera catching me.
You think we'd play if we hadn't thought that one out?
Besides, I haven't got anything to play with.
Oh, yeah, that's right. You gave me all your buy-up, didn't you? Well, I'll tell you what. I'll stake you. I'll give you half back. If you win, you can pay me back.
Thanks.
See you at the game.
If the screws aren't going to raid until halfway through the game, they'll confiscate the stakes.
It'll be worth it. Just make sure you don't hold back on the bets, otherwise she's going to get suspicious.
You don't have to do all this for me.
It's for all of us, love.
Yeah, I know. But you've always looked after me, Bea. You're the best friend I ever had.
Will you get those out of here?
What?
We're not playing with marked cards. This is legit. For crying out loud, get us a clean deck, will you, Lizzie? Get those out of here.
Oh.
She picked up my mirror.
Hey, Doy, you sure you don't want to play?
No, I'd rather watch.
All right.
Lizzie, when I get out of here, Kevin and I thought we might go away for a while, you know, to start on a fresh foot.
Are you going to sell your house?
Oh, no, we'd probably rent it, but I was wondering how you'd get out, you know, on your own, you know, without having us around.
Oh, I won't be on my own. Once Josie gets over her complications, I'll have all my own family.
Will you stop yakking and get that pack of cards?
All set.
Raring to go. There you go. I have counted it.
I haven't.
Highest card deals.
We're all seeing you.
Full hand on aces.
Oh,
what?
You should have seen what I had.
Well, I think I'll call them today.
Oh, no, you don't. Not when you're so far ahead.
I don't want to push my luck. I mean, if the officers come in.
Nice, when?
Very nice.
Deal up.
raise you.
I'll raise you 50. Go.
What are you doing?
I told you not to go up against a pro, but oh no, you wouldn't listen to me, would you?
Well, I've got to get some of this back.
So this is how you stay out of trouble, is it, White?
You bitch. You've done it again.
No, you don't, White.
I think we can believe our own eyes. Take that back, Birdsworth. Where's Doreen?
Probably got bored.
Sure she's all right? Why wouldn't she be?
Happy as a pig in mud.
Kevin wants a divorce. Didn't she tell you?
Oh, my God.
We've got to find her.
Look, none of you women are going anywhere.
Not now, Vera, I'm not in the mood.
Come on, White.
Kevin Arnold Burns. Will you love her and respect her? Be honest with her and stand by her, whatever may come, so you can genuinely share your lives together?
I will.
Doreen May Anderson. Will you love him and respect him? Be honest with him and stand by him, whatever may come, so you can genuinely share your lives together?
I will.
Nothing.
So this is how you take care of your own.
All right, White. Let's go.
Do you know what you've done to me?
Come on.
We should have known what was the matter with Dor.
Yeah. Instead, we were too busy playing funny buggers.
Kevin is coming here.
Oh, thank heavens. It could be a new start. Oh, I feel so responsible. That poor girl. If only she'd told me how she felt.
Did you try to find out?
Pardon?
Well, it seems the only time you followed up one of the women's problems, you only added to her stress because your information was so much out of date.
You can't blame me for the whole affair.
No, but I do feel you added to the pressure she was under.
I wasn't told the facts until today, and in no uncertain terms by Mrs. Jackson. But no doubt she's already given her side of the story.
I understand written reports were sent to your office earlier.
My advice was sound.
And was given without the full knowledge of Doreen's situation or her state of mind.